this past Saturday night in Bellingham High School in Bellingham, Massachusetts, Kevin Sullivan and Superfly Jimmy Snuka squared off. To a table goes Jimmy Snuka. Sullivan ramps Snuka again. Oh, Sullivan has a chair. Watch out. Oh, drew it at the back of Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
Right across the spine, Jackal. Did you see that? Lower
lumbar.
Unbelievable. Referee Scott Dickerson can't control this one. Once again, the feud that will not end.
No one can control this. These two in.
Oh,
slammed up to the table.
That ain't one of them bootleg bingo tables. You see the size of that? That's a big oak table.
Definitely hurt the back of that, man. Look. Oh, they're going to bleachers.
Uh-oh.
They're going to the bleachers.
And Sullivan is being led by Snuka this time. It's usually the other way around,
yes.
Jackal.
Oh, no. To the wall.
This past Saturday in Bellingham, if you weren't there, you missed a brawl that won't stop.
No. No way. They're pounding each other.
In the middle of the whole audience, a sellout crowd. Bellingham High School, CWA, and Sullivan and Snuka, Jackal. They've got to be contained.
Unbelievable action. Look, Snuka now. Nailed Sullivan with the chair. The top of the head.
Scott Dickerson is just window dressing. He can't control these two.
No, he can't. No way. To the corner post.
Another table's involved here, Jackal.
Unbelievable.
And look at Sullivan with those chops in the back. He had a wrench. He just threw the soda. That's a 2-liter Coke off his head.
Oh, on the table again. Oh, no, the bell's there.
He's got the wrench again. That's a monkey wrench.
Oh,
did you see that? That's what they hit the bell with, and now he's hitting the bell with it. Jimmy Snuka is being a prop for Kevin Sullivan's mayhem.
Now he's got a chair again. Oh, no.
Look at this. Kevin Sullivan throwing furniture around like
Snuka
he works at Renaissance.
Sullivan.
Now
unbelievable
what?
War.
Oh, man. And that wasn't even on the chair. That was half his body. That could have broke his spine.
He could have fell off that table and been seriously injured.
Okay, he's not. Jackal, that type of injury right there doesn't happen in professional wrestling. Maybe that's a football field or something. Where do you find this kind of athletes, Jackal? Only in pro wrestling.
Look, he's barking.
Uh-oh. Listen to that capacity crowd.
A shot by Snuka.
You sound like we're in a dog pound.
Headbutt by Snuka. Sullivan's in trouble.
And now
wait
what?
A minute.
Shabbat, newest member of the House of Horowitz, he handed Sullivan something. Did you see that?
Yes, he nailed Snuka.
He just punched him dead on, dead in the eyes.
Oh, that double team here.
And Shabbat is out there now.
Picking away on Superfly Jimmy Snuka.
Jackal, look who's coming. Look who's coming.
I don't believe it.
Unbelievable.
No way.
It's Steve Nelson from the Patriots.
I can't believe that.
Look out. Look at this. He's got Shabbat.
Oh,
clothesline.
No.
Sullivan's outside. Shabazz in the ring now by himself.
He's in trouble.
Snuka in there. And look at Nelson. That's former All-Pro, three-time All-Pro Steve Nelson. Nailing Shabazz. He's taunting Sullivan with it.
Tarabanco.
He's screaming at Sullivan. What's he saying? Wait, Sullivan, I think Sullivan's getting a microphone.
Hey, Nelson. Nelson. I'll tell you what. I know 30 Smurls.
Smurls and Nelson partners, Jackal.
And I'm gonna kick Benoit's ass. I'm gonna have Smurls in my corner. Once you get to Benoit's corner, because the girl that lives with me can kick your ass.
You heard that right here, Jackal.
That's the bleacher. That's June 9th.
CWA, WCW together in a fleet.
Woo!
You show us everything you got.
We are back. Welcome. I'm the Jagger along with the Boston Bad Boy Tony Romo. This is the Michinoku six-man match here exclusively on Mass Madness.
Just from the other day, Chelsea, Massachusetts, Jacqueline. Let's not forget what happened earlier in the top of the show. What happened just last night.
Unbelievable.
With Kevin Sullivan and Snuka and former three-time All-Pro Steve Nelson. We'll get back to that later. Let's get right to this Michinoku Pro.
Nice arm drag takedown on Taka Michinoku.
I'm glad you're here for this one, Jack. The only one I know is the Great Sasuke. Well, and the blonde wrestler right there is Terry Boy, correct?
Nice drop kick.
Now, Jack, well, this guy's name is on his back was Taka Michinoku.
Yep.
Just like the league, right?
Yes.
Yeah, this move. Oh, missed him.
Yep. Look at that nice move there. You got him right in a
spread
like
eagle.
Yes.
Like a spread eagle. See, I got to teach you some of the moves there, Jackal. Is that a...
I've lost the basics.
I'm sure you'll...
Scoop and slam.
With all the high-flying stuff, you know, I'm sure you forgot the little things. A spread eagle.
Tag made it a Great Suzuki.
Now, here he comes. We saw him a couple of weeks back against Jushin Thunder Liger.
Nice spin kick.
Now, this guy, he's wrestling right now, Jackal, in the ring with the Great Suzuki, is named after the league. Is there some significance in that?
I'm not too sure on that.
Look at those kicks.
Great Suzuki has held 7 championships with this organization in the short time it's been in operation.
And the Michinoku Pro Wrestling organization that is here today, right in Chelsea, Massachusetts, was brought to us by their liaison here in the United States, Sheldon Goldberg from Matt Marketplace, a very good friend of Century Wrestling Alliance and actually on the board of directors. And you'll be seeing him later on with another member, Howard Hoffman.
Judging by these kicks, he has a martial arts background as well as that high-flying ability. Scoop by Michinoku on Suzuki. Down he goes off the ropes.
Flying elbow. Look at
this. Terry with the elbow off the ropes.
Oh, yeah. Evidently, these guys are happy with themselves, too, huh?
They're familiar with each other. They have an ongoing feud between all 6 guys.
You'll be able to see these 6 wrestlers right here on the April 13th ECW pay-per-view, Jackal. That's correct, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Michinoku Pro Wrestling is making an impact here in the United States, and the CWA is really glad to have him. I know that personally. A little teamwork here, too.
Oh, yeah.
A little different, more style than the American wrestling fan would be accustomed to, but the great fans of Chelsea, Massachusetts appreciated this match to its fullest.
This is Shiru.
Shiru is the guy in the blue trunks
with the
Great Sasuke in the ring.
Little elbow there. Single leg trip and a half crab here.
What a beautiful afternoon it was in Chelsea, Massachusetts, huh, Jackal?
What a day.
And we're coming back March 14th, Friday night. Mass Madness returns to the Chelsea Armory, Jackal. Tickets will be on sale next week. By next Monday, you'll be able to buy tickets.
Slugfest.
Headbutt? Wow. I thought he was going to punch him and he said.
Locked.
Oh, kick right to the back of the head. What's that called?
Brain kick.
A brain kick? I thought it would have had a Japanese name.
Well, it does as well, but
isn't that called like an enziguri?
Enziguri, yes.
Yeah, see, I know a little Japanese. Look at that.
Nicely done into a pin.
Saved by Michinoku. Taka. Now, should we call him Taka or Michinoku when we talk about him, Jack?
Michinoku. I always good to go by the last name.
Okay, I wasn't sure if that was just like a prop last name or something like, you know, to take the rest of the league name.
Shoulder block. Off the ropes. Here he goes. Hip toss attempt. No, reverse. Oh, it's setting up now for something. No, not yet. He's watching his back.
Now, who is this here, Jackal, in the blue, in the mask here?
Gran Hamada.
Gran Hamada. Look at that. In quite the costumes the Japanese wrestlers come to the arena with, huh? Isn't it?
Yes, there he is. He's going to do a rope walk.
Look at this. What balance. Into an elbow drop.
Yes. Won't get him.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you have a chance
Tag to get... Tag made a great Suzuki's coming in.
Jack, like I... Oh, wait. Look at this. Suzuki. Now, see, Suzuki is a very unique wrestler.
Yes.
Very unorthodox. Right away, you don't see... Like, he takes different body parts to different extremities or whatever, and he starts pounding on him a whole different way than most American catchers.
Terry Boy's back in there.
Now, he's probably the most Americanized of these 6 guys, isn't he?
Those types remind me of Lex Luger's.
Right. Terry Boy, and he's a big fan
elbow.
Of Terry Funk, Jack. That's where the Terry Boy name comes from. Did you know that?
Yes, I did. Nice shoulder block. Down he goes, up and over Suzuki. Leapfrog. Oh, look at that.
Look at the speed.
What a power slam.
He could get him. Oh, this would be that would have been a pin heard around the world. Jack, I'll give you a little info. The other day, Sheldon Goldberg told me while they were in Massachusetts here, Michinoku Pro went on tour through Massachusetts, specifically Boston, to all the landmarks with the Great Sasuke, as they were at the Public Gardens right off Boylston Street. You know what I'm talking about,
right?
Jack, in Boston, Massachusetts. The Sasuke was walking down the street and a carload of Japanese students from MIT stopped. They slammed their brakes on and wanted pictures and autographs in the middle of Boylston Street in the Public Gardens. It's a true story. The Great Sasuke was so taken aback by that, he's already tried to make arrangements to come back here to the CWA. Matter of fact, Koji Hitari is the overseas operations director for Michinoku.
Oh, wait a minute.
What's this going to do? Oh, maybe they are. Let's see. You think this guy will be back? That's a Gran Hamada, right?
Yep. Tag made.
I thought he was
going to
throw
him.
I thought he was throwing him.
Exchanging kicks now. Dragon Screw.
What was that now?
Dragon Screw.
Not a leg drag?
No.
Okay, just checking.
No, Jim.
Do you mean old J.I.?
Yes.
That's what he calls it, right?
Yep. Another half crab here.
I'm certainly glad.
Japanese.
Now, no pun intended, right, Jackal? Isn't that a guy with a crab mat? Is he the one with a crab mask?
Yes, he is. To the outside, Hamada.
Half crab, huh? What, are you trying to be funny?
Hey, that's what it's called.
And the CWA fans are so respectful here of the great,
yes,
great traditional wrestling by the Michinoku Pro.
Up and over.
Six-man tag team. Now, what's this guy's name here, Jackal?
This is Gran Naniwa.
And he seems like he's a little older than most of the other wrestlers in the league, at least facially. Am I correct or wrong?
Yes. I'm sure he can still do it.
I'm sure not. Well, I'm saying.
Oh, back up. Leave it on his feet. Oh, he nearly caught it. In the outside goes Terry Boy.
A little miscommunication even in Japanese there.
Oh, my. Tagged
in. I think he tagged. He tagged.
Double team effort here.
Oh, maybe not. Maybe not. I'm getting mixed up here. Sasuke in
double chop. Michinoku's down.
Sasuke brings back to me
suplex.
The style that the great Muda brought here to this country, Jackal. That speed with force behind.
Sasuke's
him.
A lot quicker.
A lot quicker, but the force, you know, it's that style. Wouldn't a matchup be the great Sasuke or something like that, as we were saying before, from ECW or Sabu?
Dropping that right to the neck.
That would be an interesting matchup. What do you think, Jackal, here
in
the
States? Suzuki against anybody would be probably good, you know.
I'd like to see the extremists take on the form of some of these Japanese tag teams.
Broke up the count. Hamada came right in.
Dangerous Devin Storm, Ace Darling, and I'd like to see how they could compete in this Japanese style match right here.
Well, if Michinoku came back here to Century Wrestling Alliance, I would like to see a tag team.
Whoa!
Oh my God!
What was that? Was like a legitimate guillotine.
If the other kick was sandwiched his head together with a double drop kick.
If that was a brain kick before, what do you call that one? Oh, man. Into a crab.
No, that's a Boston crab.
And watch
a
this.
Double submission. Oh. Off the ropes, he's going to drop kick him to the face.
Oh, my. What, teamwork?
Double submission.
And the referee has no clue what's going on.
A camel clutch and a Boston crab and a drop kick right to the face.
You know, Jackal, I'll tell you right now. We say it here in this country a lot that they should have two refs during tag matches. Well, in a six-man, like, look at this.
Double armbar here.
Look at what he's doing, though. The pressure on the back of the neck is not to bend like that, Jack.
And not his either.
Oh, my. Look at this. He's
vicious kick.
Taka Michinoku in the ring now, right, Jackal?
That's right, against the great Sasuke.
And he's taunting him. I mean, he's literally showing him no respect, which you know as well as I do in Japan, is probably the lifeline of how people are treated over there. You must show respect or you're worthless in a lot of people's eyes, I guess.
And a lot of people don't realize this, but Monday morning in the Tokyo newspapers, this match was results.
And we'll have some of the magazine clips here just to show you that when they actually sent back here to us in the United States. And that's per order of Sheldon Goldberg and Koji Hitari. Every one of the Japanese magazines, there was four Japanese photographers here from different magazines. Gone, Baseball Weekly, and I'm not really familiar with the other two, Jackal, but I'm sure you might know a little bit about them. Or if not, you know I'm not lying.
Weekly Pro was one of them.
Well, there's three. Look at this.
Not going to get him.
Hey. No, he didn't get him, did he? But did you notice his Taka Michinoku? He went right over to make sure that he didn't get any help from his tag team partners either.
Of course, that's safe. Tag team wrestling.
If you ask me, Jackal, Terry Boy, Taka Michinoku.
Nice double arm suplex.
And what's the other guy's name on their team? This guy in the ring right here?
Shiro.
Other team, I think they're going to win this match. They seem much more coordinated as a tag team. They're more fluid tagging in, tagging
out.
Actually,
equally going in, but I think maybe one of them suffered from an injury on Suzuki's side.
Right, somewhere right here in this matchup here tonight, it's an advantage to the team of Taka Michinoku, Terry Boy, and Shiro. Oh, he's nailing Suzuki.
Off the ropes. Well, this backdrop.
Oh my!
He's got a floor.
Well, at least he didn't hit it as much as he could have.
Look
at Suzuki and the speed.
Wait a minute, we're going to be right back. Stay tuned.
Oh, man, what? Stay with this.
Math, a four-letter word, right? Hey, you don't need that.
Why design the world's newest chips?
When you could be flipping the world's oldest burger. Hey, wait a minute. This is math. Geometry, algebra.
No pocket protectors here.
But you're cruising without math. Yeah, right. Take a good look.
That's math staring back at you.
It's not a problem, man.
It's an answer. Call NACME. We'll tell you what you need to do.
We're back. You didn't miss a thing. Captured suplex by Terry Boy.
Good thing we have Lieutenant Basikowski there from the Chelsea Police Department to keep the fans in line, Jackal. Boy, was that a mayhem scene, huh?
Oh.
Everything back into the ring. The fans are back set up.
Hamada, no, wait a minute. Look at this double team. Oh, he missed. Oh, clothesline.
Hamada finally makes it over again to Suzuki.
Double team again.
Right away. One man against two is very difficult to do that.
Duck the clothesline.
Look at that.
Slingshot moonsault on two men by Suzuki.
Oh, just too smooth, Jackal. Way too smooth. Look at this one.
Oh!
Look at that.
Handspring into a high cross body by Suzuki.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you... Oh, watch this.
No, he's going to block it. Oh, what a spin kick. To the outside.
Oh, you can't even catch your breath in this one. Look at that. Oh, caught himself and kicked him right in the face.
Quebrada by Suzuki.
Quebrada by Suzuki sounds like a new thing.
Unbelievable.
Unbelievable, Jackal. We can't say it enough.
They're out.
Well, it's got to affect him. I don't care if it's the guy.
We have a chair in the ring. It's not if he uses a weapon, however.
Well, launching pad.
Springboard off the door. He missed. Oh, now it's a weapon.
Now it's the weapon. Unbelievable. The understatement word of the day is unbelievable.
Oh!
And there it is again.
Giant body press, and he put him a twisting DDT.
And a save by Terry Boy. Gran Hamada's in the ring.
Unbelievable.
And Terry Boy and Gran Hamada. Who's the legal man?
I don't know. I think Suzuki's one.
And I ain't talking immigration, Jack. I'm
Rob
talking Toho, this match.
Rapping over Dandino.
Look at this. He got him.
No, he doesn't.
No. How can this referee keep track?
The junior heavyweight, that Dandine is a famous finishing move. Tombstone, no!
Jack, well, I'm going to tell you right now, if this ain't the greatest match in CWA history, I don't know what is.
Well, that's true.
Look at that! Oh, my God! Gee,
he did a springboard plancher in one motion.
What are you kidding? Cut it out. This ain't cartoons, Jack. I mean, I haven't seen anything like that since the Roadrunner or something. What are you out of here?
Oh, what?
Devastating.
He lifted him and he
got
a
face buster on his knee.
Got a bulldog there.
I think he got him on his knee. He can't even tell what's going on. It's so fast. Well, I could tell you what happened right there. Little miscommunication.
Again.
Jekyll, if you weren't in Chelsea, look at this one.
On the floor.
You better get there March 14th. I got to tell you that, Jekyll, right?
His arm drag. Shoulder block there off the ropes.
Another
slingshot moonsault.
Slingshot moonsault?
When it's inside the ring, slingshot moonsault.
And if it's outside, it's a quebrada?
Yep.
I got you. Look at this. Plants him.
He did. That's
done.
It.
Oh, man.
Suzuki wins yet again.
Jekyll, I don't know how to say it, man, but that was the greatest match I've seen in CWA. Unbelievable.
And we must see the Great Sasuke again here in a CWA.
Listen to the crowd. They're into this big time. They came into this building, into a foreign country, unknown. They're leaving the stars of the show, Jack.
Unbelievable.
Once again, what did you say, Jackal?
We'll be back.
Here's my nephew Scrump, about to run into trouble again.
Hey, Bobo, where's your video game?
In here.
Oh, look at this.
Oh, it's my dad. So want to hold it?
What'll I do?
You'll see, but that's not the only problem he has.
Hey, here's a shortcut.
Not down there, Square.
I don't think it's safe. Come on, the coast is clear.
I'm not taking a chance, Lance.
Oh, no.
Well, well, hello, dog face. Come to give us your sneakers.
Uh-oh. Trouble again, Scruff. What are you going to do now?
I don't know.
If you get my new comic activity book, More Adventures with Scruff, you'll find out what you can do about bullies, drugs, and guns.
Am I the hero again?
You'll see. And you'll see lots of games.
Cool.
For your free copy of my new comic activity book, write Scruff McGruff, Chicago, Illinois, 60652. Scruff McGruff, Chicago, Illinois, 60652. And you'll be helping take a bite out of crime.
I want it!
Terrell Bishop is angry and taking to the street again tonight. To take it back from pushers and gangs and make it safe for his four-year-old.
We go out there and patrol the streets and talk to the youngsters.
Terrell is a mad dad. Family men who work with local authorities to keep their neighborhoods safe.
We try to get them away from the gang life because a lot of us, that's part of Mad Dads, are ex-gang members.
It's time for the men to stand up and be men and take their part and do what is needed so our young kids can grow up in a safe environment.
Just making a lot of people feel a lot safer by us being out there, walking around.
Every child should have a man in their life, a positive man in their life.
Not everyone has to take to the streets, but everyone can take a step to help kids. Call us. We're fighting for the children. Whose side are you on?
On behalf of CWA, all the wrestling fans here, we thank you for coming all the way from Japan to show the CWA fans the best wrestling in the world. Domo arigato. Thank you very much.
And that was Sheldon Goldberg, the board of directors, along with Kali Hoffman, also board of directors, Tony Rumble, Century Wrestling Alliance superstar, ring announcer Rich Palladino, the awards presentation for the winners of the Michinoku six-man matchup. And this, between Michinoku Pro, the Century Wrestling Alliance, the United States, unbelievable. And Suzuki appreciated this because this is a custom in the country of Japan. After they win major tournaments, they're presented not only a championship belt, but a trophy as well. Balls going on there is respectable. That's custom as well. Michinoku Pro Wrestling comes to the Century Wrestling Alliance.
Domo arigato. Domo arigato. まだこの後試合も控えてるんで、手短にお話したいと思います。通訳、今日我々道のくプロレス軍団が、本日で3日目になるんですが、今日が最終日です。昨日、おとといとこのボストン周辺巡って、今日この CWA 初めて来ました。まずここまで。
Thank you for coming for tonight for 道のくプロレス。This is the first time coming to United States. And this is the last night for Massachusetts and first time for CWA.
この CWA の、お客さんを見て、私のホームタウンである、日本の東北という街を思い出しました。
When Sasuke sees CWA fans, he reminds him Michinoku fans in his town.
とにかくこの3日間で私が感じたことは、このプロレスを通じて、プロレスを通じれば地球に国境はないということです。
When he felt, what he felt is go through this wrestling business, He wanna do something for this peace for the world.
我々は今後世界平和のために紛争が続くイラクそしてイスラエルに行って我々のプロレスで人々を平和にしたいと思います。
For us peace, he's gonna use this wrestling to go to the Iraq and the Iran for the peace.
そしてまたこの CWA のこの町に必ず戻ってきます。今日は応援ありがとうございました。
And last of all, definitely he will be back sometime soon for CWA in this town. Thank you very much.
I for one hope the Great Sasuke and the Michinoku Pro Wrestling Superstars do indeed return here to the Century Wrestling Alliance and Mass Madness. What a wrestling moment. Join us next week for more Mass Madness.